where the Earth's magnetic field caused this supervolcano to explode? Well, it's highly possible. The Gakkel Ridge is a mid-ocean spreading center in the North Atlantic Ocean, home of one of the largest known supervolcanoes on our planet. Gakkel is approximately 63 miles, 68 miles across, 1.2 kilometers deep. And we're going to be looking at the volume too, because there's a big difference between Yellowstone and Gakkel Ridge. Also, the Earth's magnetic North Pole began moving from its location in Canada towards Siberia over the last 100 years, accelerating rapidly. But also, as it moves forward, its movement has been passing directly through Gakkel Ridge supervolcano zone this year. Earth's magnetic pole in the northern hemisphere is where the energy flows into our planet, especially during space weather events such as CMEs and coronal holes. But geophysics suggests that the link exists between the solar activity, earthquakes, volcanic activity here on Earth. But if you think about it, could this happen again? Yes, it could. And we may or may not witness it, ladies and gentlemen. This section one basically is an overview of Earth's magnetic field in Gakkel Ridge, as well as geophysics in part two, Gakkel Ridge and the Corvera. And then section three, the movement of the magnetic north and its energy effects upon everyone, including the beautiful auroras. But also geophysics explains, and I'm going to use certain terms that are not going to, you have to, you know, stop and look it up. You don't have to do that. I'm going to break it down about as easy as I can. I know it's a pretty heavy subject, but also the bar magnet. Well, it's directly over the Gakkel supervolcano. The magnetic north is strengthening because of the geomagnetic storms that we're having. This is the grand solar maximum. And the south will become north and the north will become south. But when you look at the Earth's magnetic field, it represents a field of a large dipole bar magnet, actually. That's the best I can give it to you. And it's in the center of the Earth, and the Earth's field is more complex through a number of higher orders through the poles, as one is weakening, the other gains its strength. And this anomaly affects is basically the size, shape, and strength of the Earth's magnetic field crossing and changing across the space and time of this scale. If you look at the red arrow at the bottom, notice the direction of the magnetic force energy flows into the North Pole. And also on the top right, that illustration shows you how it's increasing. But all of this is connected through the geomagnetic storms that we're having, and it goes right into the magnetic north, causing the auroras. And this illustration is the United States and UK world magnetic model for 2020. Now, they have the information, but from what I understand, they're restricting us. They're not going to give it to us. And if you look at the side of the left, that gray area is where the magnetic pole was back in 2020, as you can see the red circumference. Right there it is. Now, the magnetic pole in the northern hemisphere is actually a magnetic south pole with a inward flow of energy. So I'm going to take you to the location, and we're going to be looking at it in many, many different ways. But right there on the right, the tectonic plates of the volcanic forces or the impact of an event are needed to create a basin this large. And given the availability of the evidence, a big supervolcano eruption is the best I can explain. It's happened before, 1.1 million years ago, and it was a VEI-8, actually. Now, this is the volume. Look at it. Look at Yellowstone's caldera, and then look at the Gakkel caldera. It's three times the size of Yellowstone, everyone. Think about that. This is huge because the magnetic north is in that area, and we're going to cover it in this presentation, the current position of the magnetic north. And there was a earthquake, a small one, in the center of it. But since the 1800s, it's been moving from Canada into Siberia, as you can see here, right through here. And this is the 45 degree mark. But when you look at the enhanced lithosphere during this process and what took place with the electromagnetism, it is a fundamental force capable of changing everything, causing physics change to energy, strength, and active power. The magnetic pole of the Earth's northern hemisphere is a inward facing. In this illustration, this goes back to 1999 when the earthquake started taking place, and the black triangles, those are basically seismograph activity stations. I hope you can see them all. But back in 1999, the highest magnitude event of earthquakes took place, 15 actually. It was a magnitude 5 in that area, 252 in that area as well. One of them was a magnitude 5.8 and a 6. So that's telling me that the earthquakes that took place back then can happen again, ladies and gentlemen. And we're going to be looking at different areas of this area of the Gakkel Ridge. But it's really an interesting subject. But let's look at what's underneath, the underwater. Look at this footage. Now, this is the center of the caldera. As you can see, it's a deep chamber. Very, very deep. So they have the evidence, but also the evidence dealing with the earthquakes that took place back in 1999. So could it happen again? I like to read your comments. It's possible. You know what I say, highly possible. Keep me out of trouble. Okay. So the earthquakes that took place back in 1999, as you can see in this illustration at the bottom, in the circumference, there was 252 earthquakes, and they ranged from a magnitude 3 all the way up to a 5.8. Other researchers said it was a magnitude 6. But when you look at the slow migration of the largest earthquakes are going into that area, these events among the axes of the rift or the valley suggest that multiple magnetic pulses were taking place in the upper mantle, spreading the rates. Here, as you can see, a 1.5 to a magnitude 6 earthquake did take place back in December 2016 and January of 2020, circled in the circumference. Now, when you think about volcanism and what that is, it's basically the Earth's crust collapsing on the water table, but the Earth's crust can collapse in the caldera as well. Now, in this illustration, you can see the type of volcanism that has taken place in the, as well as spreading in that area. The fragments are from a pyroclastic deposit. But also, look at the large reserve, should I say, and I'm going to show it to you. It's the largest plume in that area. But you can see the mantle, the elliptic sphere, which I did a special video on, and how it's increasing and it's pushing upward. Now, the pyroclastic deposits are very important. So, the plume, the largest plume on this planet, is right there. Wow. And it's starting to come upward. They have measured it back in 2017. That it was a slight uplift. But don't worry, it's not going to happen for another million years. Right? I've heard that before. Just like the continent of Africa is splitting. And an individual from USGS said, well, won't happen for 300,000 years. But the Gakkel Ridge is very important to understand. It's a high volcanic area. And it deals with a lot. It deals with the gases that could be released. It could release a number of type of carbon dioxide could be released, as you can see in the previous illustrations, carbon dioxide. But we're going to be looking at a lot in this one. Now, if you look at the seafloor core, how it's expanding and pushing upward, and the depth may not look like that much, okay? But the movement is taking place. It's changing, everyone. And let's go here, and I'm going to show you something that's very impressive. The movement of the magnetic north between the flux coils, the flux loops, I like to call them the loops. You have a closed loop and an open loop. But the magnetic north pole is simply a location that we call, you know, north pole. It can be confusing, but there's a geomagnetic, but also a GPS location as well, and it's constantly moving. But between 1999 and 2019, you can see the difference between the two quite a bit. And the South Atlantic Anomaly, I talked about that a number of times. But when you look at the flux tube and how one side is weakening from Siberia and the other side is gaining its strength. So back in 2007 was the last direct measurement from the federal government, which has it. NOAA shut it off, okay? And that's a government agency. Why did they do that? So back in 2010 and 2015, 2020, and 2025, the model did not work right. They did not put in about the geomagnetic storms increasing for the grand solar maximum. So they missed it. We're over there on the right side now. And solar flares, especially a X-class, is very important. But the elliptic sphere and the anionic sphere is weakening. That's at the top. The elliptic sphere is at the bottom, above the Earth's mantle, upper mantle. And geomagnetism, pulses, charged particles, charged ions, and the energies coming in from our elliptic sphere, because it's down to 70% now. Some of you may experience ringing in the ears, having dreams, but also when you look how many is coming in right now. So let's go here and look at the sunspot number, how it's progressing, okay? And here we go. Back in January 2013, reached its peak. Now, that was the solar maximum. This is the minimum area. And now you can see in 2022, that's when the earthquakes took place over Gakkel Ridge. And 2023, May of 2024, June, August. And now it's slowly dropping off just a little bit, September. And this area of October. And now we're at November. So I believe we're going to see more peaks and geomagnetic storms, and solar winds are going to increase as well. Now, going back to Thursday, November the 7th, okay, this is for 24 hours. A number of M classes taking place. A number of C classes taking place. Right there was an M1. M1. M1.8. Friday. Okay. The 8th. So I hope this all gives you an understanding of what's taking place. It's not over with. Okay. That's an M1 right there. It took place Saturday on the 9th. When you look at it, it's really fascinating. Now we're going to go over the earthquakes. I'm going to take you to the USGS, of course, and we're going to complete the educational part. I hope you all enjoyed it. It took me hours upon hours to put it together. And wow, we are having record number of magnitude 6 earthquakes. Today, another one hit in Cuba. And the seismograph activity. Well, this just happened. A 7.1 just hit Cuba, and they just got hit earlier this morning with a magnitude 6.1. So I'm going to share something with you. About 4 weeks ago, I was sitting right here at my desk, and the Lord told me that I will be here because a large earthquake will hit. And it happened. A 7. Magnitude 7.1. And as you know, a magnitude 7 is 33 times the magnitude of a 6. 6.6 million people will be affected by this in this area. See the green spots, the red spots, the yellow. 6.6 people will be affected by this one in Cuba. They don't have the building codes that we do here in the United States. A tsunami warning went out, but it hasn't been reported yet. Ongoing aftershocks will continue as this video is being recorded. So now we're going to go to USGS and take it from there. So here we are at USGS, and for 30 days they're stating 7,772 earthquakes have taken place. The largest is right here. They're going to be in blue, everyone. 7.1. 6.5 hit Costa Rica. Another 6.5 hit Russia right here. Okay, follow me. A 6.5 in Chile. A 6.3 hit Turkey. A 6.3 again, Papua New Guinea. Oregon had a magnitude 6.3. I don't have the depth on that one. That one's very important. Again, Palawan, New Guinea had a 6.3. A magnitude 6.2 hit Afghanistan. Oh, there's so many, everyone. And then right here in Mexico, a 6.2 happened right here. I mean, the list goes on and on and on, but there was a total of 20 magnitude 6 earthquakes have taken place in the past 30 days. So now let's go to 7 days. For 7 days, according to USGS, 247 earthquakes. It was 2.5 and higher. And again, well, we know about the 7.1 that hit Cuba. And then Chile had a 6.5. Cuba had the 6.2. Fuji had a 6.2. Palawan, New Guinea had a 6.2. The Panama had a 6.1. Okay. Another 6.1 that has taken place right here, and we're going to focus on this area. This is the Mariana Trench. I've never seen that many fives that has hit, and we're going to get to that here in a brief moment. Right there. Okay. So there was another magnitude 6 that hit Peru. And then Panama had a 5.9. Mid Indian Ridge had a 5.8. But let's go ahead and look at for 1 day. Now, for 1 day, magnitude 2.5 or higher, they're stating 30 earthquakes. Okay, and we know about the large one right there, 7.1. Okay, this is for 1 day. And then right here in Cuba, the 6.2 that hit New Zealand, down here, had a 5.5. I don't have it registered today because it just happened. So now let's go to Volcano Discovery and see what they have to say. So for the last 30 days, there has been 29,142 earthquakes. And a lot of them was a magnitude 5 to a 6, 131. This has got my attention right here. 1,110 earthquakes from a magnitude 4 to a 5. And then look at this number. 3,154 earthquakes for a magnitude 3 to a 4. And then 6,696 earthquakes from a magnitude 2 to a 3. And then 18,045 earthquakes from a magnitude 1 and higher. So a lot's going on. But let's look at for the last 7 days. Now, I'm going to make a statement. I caught that earthquake before it took off. And I did not refresh it. They're stating a 6.8 that hit Cuba. But for 7 days, there has been a total of 6,633 earthquakes. Now, I would have to go back and refresh in this because, you know, I had to go outside and catch my breath and calm down for a little bit. Okay? But I'm grateful that I was here before it got downgraded. Okay? So, there's a lot of shaking going on, everyone. And I'm not going to cover for the past 24 hours, okay? Let's look at the earthquakes in a different perspective. What I'm getting at, I'm going to bring this up for 7 days. 3,862 earthquakes for 7 days. Let's see how many volcanoes is going off. So, current eruptions of the volcanoes for November the 10th. Eruptions are going to be in red, of course, down through here in Central America, also South America, South Sandwich region, Africa, Mount Etna, all the way down through here. This is Indonesia. These events in Palawan, New Guinea, New Caledonia, and way down here, okay? A lot's going on up here in Russia, but also this area, the southern part of Japan, and the Mariana Trench, in which we're going to cover. And we're going to be looking at these volcanoes that are going off right over here. Indonesia, two of them, actually. So there has been a total of 36 eruptions taking place throughout the world. In red. Yellow is minor activity, I always call them vents. There has been 33. So it has not changed in 3 weeks. There's a total of 69 volcanoes that are going off throughout the world, according to Volcano Discovery. So, let's check out the map and let's go do it and see what's happening. Before we get started, I usually start out in the South Sandwich region, but we're going to look at this one. This is the area of the 7.1 that hit Cuba today. Bring this in for you, of course. And this is the area. This is the 6.2, 8.8 miles in depth. And of course, these are the aftershocks right here. This is the 4.9. I'm gonna bring this out for you right here. 4.9, 9.5 miles in depth. And then there was another one, 4.5, only 10 miles in depth. Wow. So while we're here, ladies and gentlemen, let's check out the Caribbean plate. Okay. This is the Caribbean plate right here. And we know that there was a 6 recorded. Bring this up for you. This is it. And that happened back in June 22nd, 6.3, 54 miles in depth. .5, 46 miles in depth on the 9th. And out here, this is really strange, okay? Right here, at 4.6, and that happened on the 7th, just a couple of days ago. And we already know about this one. So what I'm thinking is the plates are making a huge adjustment with the Caribbean plate. I have never seen it like this. All the years I've been researching earthquakes, I've never seen a 6.2 in this area. And now there's a 7.1. Interesting, isn't it? Well, I'm concerned about the people in Cuba. I really am. So now, let's pick it up at the South Sandwich region. There was only a magnitude 5 in this area. It was a 5.4, 63 miles, and that happened on the 7th, and that's the only thing that's going on down through here. You can see all these 6s. And I made a statement on the last update that I believe we're going to see a 6.5 or higher in this region. Okay, so let's look at South America. We're going to pick it up right here. 6.5. Don't have the depth. If you don't see it, I don't have it. I guess USGS doesn't have it either. And that happened on the 8th, just a couple of days ago. We'll get to the what's happening in the Pacific plate here in a brief moment. This is a VEI-4, okay, that took place, Chile. But there was a number of 4s and 5s in this area, not as many as usual. This is a 5.7, 117 miles in depth on the 2nd. 4.6, 42 miles on the 7th. .6, 22 miles in depth, happened on the 5th. Now we're going to stick with the program. I'm not usually at the end of the month I go over the big ones, but not today because of the educational part. A 4.6, 28 miles, that happened on the 2nd. Another one right here, 4.9, 23 miles in depth on the 8th. Another one again, small one, 4.6, 69 miles in depth on the 3rd. And there was a 5 in this area, 5.1, 68 miles on the 7th. We know about the 7.7 that hit. Basically back in July on the 18th, from what I remember. These are clusters. Anytime you see all that cluttered up together, those are clusters. A 5.3, 73 miles on the 6th. There was a magnitude 5.0, 160 miles. That's a deep focus earthquake on the 3rd. And we know what happened in September right here. There was a magnitude 6 deep focus earthquake, 138 miles. 4.8, 98 miles in depth, and that happened on the 4th. But there was another one right next to it, if I can find it. Okay, right here, 4.7, 99 miles in depth, and that happened on the 7th of this month. We're not going to cover all these. Okay, I said we wouldn't, so I'm not, even though I can change my mind because I have the right to. Okay. 7.5, only 17 miles in depth, and that happened in June. But let's focus on this one. On the 6th, a 5.3, 34 miles in depth, right there. This is the one. Magnitude 6, 49 miles in depth. That happened basically a few days ago on the 5th, about 5 days ago. Not going to cover these. Not going to cover that other than the 5.4 that took place. Right here, 121 miles. Anything above 121 miles is 120 miles. Excuse me, it's a deep focus earthquake. Right here, Columbia, 5.3, 24 miles in depth, happened on the 4th. And we did have one in this area. Okay, right down through here. This is a tectonic plate, 4.7, 90 miles, and that happened at the end of this month. I bring it back because I wanted to let everybody know that I'm expecting a large one to hit right through here. Anytime you see a 90 degree turn on a tectonic plate, that's where it's going to be happening. Okay, and of course we already covered this area. Now we're getting into Central America. I'm concerned about Panama. I'm going to bring this in for you. Panama had the 6.1. No doubt. Happened yesterday. This video is being recorded on the 10th. Okay. No doubt. Right here at 5.9, almost another 6. That happened on the 9th. Stroll up through here. And right here was a 4.9. That happened on the 2nd. Okay. And this is 6.5. That happened of October in that area. Right here. Now, this was a magnitude 4.5. Happened on the 3rd. But there's something going on with these volcanoes right now. And I'm going to give it to you here in a moment. Right there, 5.4. 42 miles, Nicaragua. This right here for the work, right? On the 4th was a 4.5, 21 miles. And then on the 7th, a 4.6, 29 miles in depth. Right here, a 4.7, 51 miles in depth, happened on the 3rd. In here, in this area, today, at 4.7, 36 miles, that happened today, in the depth. And then we're getting up into this area, but I want to take a break, okay? I could use a break today. So, let's look at this volcano that went off in Guatemala, I believe. So let's do that. So the reason I wanted to focus on that one, here it is right here. I'm going to bring this in for you so you can see what I'm talking about. This one, there's three of them actually. And this is it right here. Heavy populated area. But got this one and then another one and another one. And another one, and another one, and another one. What I'm getting at, that Central America is number one in the world for volcanoes per square mile. Okay? And right here, this is some wonderful friends of mine right here. This is Sister Kimberly and Brother Randy. They run the nonprofit organization of the food bank, and the link is always in the description box. I'm sure they got a little awakening on this one. Even though it was small, it happened today. And it was a magnitude 4.7, 36 miles in depth. There they are. So I'm sure they definitely felt that one. love both of you. Both of you so much. Thank you for all the work you're doing in Mexico to help the people down there. Link is in the description box if you want to donate. And this area right here, Baja Palencia, no activity in months. So I believe what's going to happen is this magnitude 6 going to go to a 6.5 or higher. When it does, I made the statement before, once it goes off 6.5 or higher, not a 6, okay, remember 33 times, that there will be a 2.5 somewhere in this region that's going to last for 5 minutes, and that's unheard of, and then there won't be any activity for 36 to 42. 8 hours, and then I'm predicting a magnitude 9.5 or higher will be in this region. If it's a 10.5, This is the San Andreas fault line, the southern part from this fracture right here, Los Angeles, down through here. It's going to slide off into the Pacific Ocean. That's just my perspective. And then let's just say it was a 10.5. I'm going to give you an example because this video is running over and I want everyone to understand what I'm getting at. So let's just say it was a 10.5. It's happened before, okay? And it could happen again. Let's say it was a 10.5, okay? Hypothetically. By the time it gets way over here, this is the New Madrid. It will be downgraded to a 7.5. That could set off a chain reaction, okay, to the New Madrid. You follow me? I believe so. Now, we will continue. If that happens, everyone, it will send a shock wave, okay, all the way up through here. And, of course, this is the red zone, okay, cascade subduction zone. And then once it takes off, well, Hawaii's going to get the worst of it, okay? Hawaii will. From a mega tsunami, okay? Now, last week, there was a lot going on in this area. Just want to cover it briefly. And thank you for the wonderful subscriber on YouTube that lives in Hawaii. So there was a magnitude 4 right here. Magnitude 4.3. This is the area that I believe we're going to see another underwater volcano go off. And right here was the 5.1 that took place on the 5th. Back in February is magnitude 6. And if the water from California, the West Coast, went up through here, right up through here. All of this is only about 300 to 400 feet elevation, not the mountains, okay? I'm gonna bring this in for you so you know what I'm talking about, okay? That water come right up through here. That right there is very, very shallow. About 130 feet above sea level. Not much. So anyhow, let's get back to the program. Let's do that and move over here. North this out for you. Okay. As far as what's going on the West Coast, not a whole lot right now. This is the one fluke plate. A lot of activity in that area over the last couple of months. Okay. Red zone. This is where I believe it's going to be a future underwater volcano. And this area right here is where the 6.7 hit off the coast of Canada back in July the 11th. Now we're strolling up in here to Alaska, okay? And this is the area of the Great Alaskan Earthquake back in 1964, 9.5. But right here, this is very strange. A 5.2, only 8 miles in depth, out in the middle of nowhere, 2 hours from somewhere, or more like 5 or 6 hours from somewhere, okay? Happened on the 8th. There was a magnitude 4.7, happened on the 8th, just a couple days ago. Now you're going to find it to get very interesting. 6.3 happened. Excuse me. Bring this back to so many sixes, 6.3, 25 miles a day. And that happened on July the 8th. And then there's another one, 6.3. That happened May the 19th. But now we're going to get over here, because this is where it's going to get interesting. I'm not talking about the 4. I'm talking about the 6. 6.1, 20 miles a day. That happened on the 3rd. Okay. Right here. This is a 4.5, 21 miles a day. On the 3rd. This right here is where the 5.1 hit, 21 miles a dump on the 8th, so that's the aftershock. They're all jammed up together. 4.7, 28 miles a dump on the 8th. So, this is a chain of volcanoes, of course. The reason I'm going over some of this, because this is going to go on YouTube. Okay. 6.1 chain of volcanoes. Now we're getting into Rat Alley. 8.7 took place in 1965. Getting into Russia now. And of course, I'm going to morph this out for you. It seems that I'm getting, you know, a little fatigued, because I am. Been staying up at night, and I have been sick. 4.7, 46 miles a day, happened a couple days ago. I believe there's another one. There it is, right there. 4.9, 29 miles a day. Happened on the 8th. Magnitude 6.2. Not going to talk about that. Not going to talk about the 9 that hit in 1952. Not going to talk about this one either, but we're going to talk about this one. It was a 5.6 deep focus earthquake, 358 miles to place this area. Right here. 4.7, 250 miles, happening the second of this month. Getting down through here, this is Japan. So there have been some activity. We're going to go over it before we get into the Mariana Trench. That right there is a 4.7, 42 miles in depth on the 8th of this month. Another one right here on the 4th, 4.9, 43 miles in depth. And of course, this is Triple Junction. I believe what we're going to witness right here any day now, any week or any month, a mega quake, a 4.8, excuse me, a magnitude 8 to a 9 or higher. I do apologize if you want to be doing a lot of work and I haven't been feeling too well. Magnitude 5.3. Don't have the depth on the 8th. Now it's going to get interesting, okay? I have never, ever in my whole career keeping up with earthquakes seen anything like this at all. It's over 22. Within 48 hours, magnitude 5s are everywhere in this cluster. And right here, if I can find it, okay, all down through here. And there was a magnitude 6 that hit this week right here, 6.2. They all cluttered up. Okay, 6.2, don't have the depth. And that happened a few days ago. But look at all of these. This took hours for me to put together. Look at all these fives. Let's start back up here. 5.2, 36 miles of depth on the 9th. Magnitude 5, 18 miles of depth on the 7th. Another one right here, 5.2. I'm not going to call the depth out because there's so many. 4.9, 7th. Magnitude 5, 7th. 5.3. On the 6th, 5.2 on the 8th, see what I mean? A lot, all down through here. I mean, I can go on and on that this video is running over, but look at them, they're everywhere. I have never seen this before. 4.9, 5.0, okay, right here in this area. But also, all down through here, and they're moving south. This is 4.6, 16 miles in depth on the 8th. Wow, I have never, ever, my whole career, ladies and gentlemen, keeping up with earthquakes, has seen anything like this. Never. So that's telling me that the area right down through here, this is the major fault line right here, tectonic plate. Okay, the Mariana Trench is definitely waking up, and I believe it could split open, but not going to get any news video on it. Takes a submarine to look at that crack. I mean, let me give you a quick example. Take you right here, this is the deep part. And you're looking at 21,000 feet. 7.1. Okay, so let's go back up to the southern part of Japan. See what else is going on. Okay, we already covered these. There was some activity right here, right next to 7.1, 4.8. 27 miles, and that happened yesterday on the 9th. Okay. We know about the 6. Right here, next to another 6. This was 5.2, 21 miles in depth, happened on the 7th. So a lot of activity is going on in this region. And then on the 2nd, there was a 5 right there. So they're coming downward, it seems to be. Now, for this week, there was some activity in Taiwan, 5.3 on the 6th. Move this out for you. I believe there was another one somewhere on the 5th, right there. Okay. And it was a 4.9, 23 miles in depth. Look at all these 6s down through here. Okay. Drove south, getting into the Philippines on the 4th of this month, a 5.0, 21 miles in depth. It's a VEI-6, Luzon volcano. ...4.9, 50 miles in depth, that happened on the 8th. Right here, next to the 7.1, right here, okay, next to the 6.6, follow me, okay, right there on the 4, 5.2, don't have the depth, wow, crazy. ...5.0... 42 miles in depth. This took place on the 2nd. Move over here to Indonesia. 5.2, 33 miles in depth, happened on the 8th. Now we're getting into a very, very interesting area, Indonesia. 4.8, 165 miles in depth. That happened on the 8th, deep focus earthquake. 4.8, 80 miles, happened on the 6th. Happened on the 4th, 4.7, okay. Right here. It's 5.1, deep focus earthquake, 155 miles. But we're going to be looking at something again, if that's okay. But after this one, 4.8, 64 miles of depth, happened on the 3rd. But something happened. Wonder what it was. Let's check it out. I believe it has something to do with a volcano.
Lari, turun dengan apa ini, pasir batu, asap api, kami lari kayak malam, kami lari ke pesenter.
Tidak baku lihat ya, Mama?
Tidak, ke pesenter.
Ke pesenter ya?
Lama, macam malam.
Mama, itu pas Mama ya, Pak?
Over 20 people have perished around this volcano. Probably more than that now. It just erupted 2 days ago. This one here has not went off yet. Mandatory evacuation is what they're fixing to call in Indonesia. Look at this area. Thousands of people. They're going to have to evacuate. The magma's going to come right down through here. So, it hasn't happened. But let's look at that video as well. I'm talking about this one. Possible tsunami threat. This is an update. It's a possibility a threat could hit this area. Because it's increasing signs of unrest soon to erupt. I'm particularly talking about this area. where the rocks were shifting from the vibration of the earthquakes that have taken place. Small, very small. USGS is not even recording them. But it's shifting towards the south. And you remember what happened in Thailand when it shifted and caused the earthquake that went north and killed 252,000 people, and it was a tsunami, 23 feet when it first came in, and it was 60 feet. This is the area right here, and it's facing south, not north, like Thailand. I believe this week coming up, it could happen. I'm predicting it will. This is the area, just a small populated area. Mandatory evacuation in this area as well. Beautiful. But it did erupt back in 1969, was the last eruption. And there's three volcanoes. Two of them are dormant, but the other one is not. The main one is not. And it is producing a lot of earthquakes, one a day. And then November 13 and November the 6th, 47. But USGS is not showing it. Sulfur smell. H2S. Okay. That's basically acid gas. You breathe it into your lungs. And you're dead. It smells like rotten eggs. That gas is well known in the oil refineries. Sulfur dioxide. I believe it's going to happen. It's already releasing the gas from the plumes. I just wanted to take up a little bit of your time to let you know what's going on in these areas. Okay. I believe it's going to take place very, very soon. And this is the scale. Okay. It's very high. Right there. 6. Unusual activity. Wow. 69 volcanoes going off right now. It's crazy. Anyhow, just wanted to show you. But what's happening right now is the magma is coming upward, okay? And it's rising. So that's telling me within the next couple of days, if not sooner, it's going to happen. Amazing. So anyhow, let's get back to the program. I just wanted to educate everyone on this specific area of Indonesia. Wow, let's go pick it up again. So we're going to pick up the program, continue on. We still have quite a bit to cover. This right here was on the 3rd. It was a 4.8, only 64 miles. Nothing going on down through here. So that means something will go down through there within the next week or so. 4.9, 26 miles and down on the 8th. One right here, 4.5, happened on the 2nd of this month. We're not going to get into this area just yet of China. We're going to pick it up in the eastern part of Indonesia. 4.9. 36 miles in depth, happened on the 9th. 5.2. 8.2 miles, very shallow, happened on the 9th. 4.9. 58 miles in depth, happened on the 6th. Way up here, to the north, 5.3. 12 miles in depth, and that happened on the 3rd. Right next to this one, 6.6. That happened in September. This area, this is the main fracture. I believe this area of Palawan, New Guinea is about to split this island in half. That's my personal perspective. Right here we have a magnitude 5.2, 31 miles in depth. That happened on the 2nd. Two of them back to back, but here's the main one for this week. A 6.3 right here. Happened on the 6th, 32 miles. Very shallow earthquake from my perspective. But again, this one right here was 5.5, 56 miles of depth, happened on the 7th. Right next to the 4.8, 81 miles, happened on the 7th. Stroll down through here. This area on the 4th, 4.8, 154 miles, deep focus earthquake. Right here, this is the area of New Caledonia. Nothing's really going on. It was the number of sixes in this area a few months ago. More. Now we're getting into this area of Fuji. Big earthquake depth in this area. This is just a 4.7. 374 miles in depth. This is the one that took place this week, a big one, 6.3, 268 miles deep focus earthquake on the 6th. Now we're going to go down through this fracture right down through here before we get into Tonga. Okay. 5.4. 364 miles in depth. Ladies and gentlemen, that's by the upper mantle. Okay. Another one right here. 5.3. 356 miles in depth. Okay. On the 11th. So you have the Earth's crust. And then you have the upper mantle, and this is what's happening, okay? Magnitude 4.7. 323 miles. That's by the upper mantle of the ecliptic sphere. Happened on the 11th. Right here. 5.0. 333 miles, and that happened on the 9th. Another one, 4.9. 358 miles, happened on the 8th. Ladies and gentlemen, this is, you have the Earth's crust and the ecliptic sphere, the upper mantle. This is deep focus earthquakes right here. 4.8, 318 miles. Happened on the 8th. They're going south. This is a fracture, okay? Not a major fault line. Getting back up in here to the north part of Tonga. Nothing going on but some sixes in this area. Okay, look at them. Okay. But there was a few fives in this area, around the area of the magnitude sixes. 5.0, 136 miles in depth. Happened on the 9th. Right here, 5.3, Tonga. That happened on the 4th. Right next to the 6.3. Right here was the 6.3, another one. September the 7th, 5.0. Only 21 miles. Happened on the 9th. covered this area. We're soon fixing to get into a giant cluster that took place last week. 4.9 on Habitat, happened on the 9th. 5.5 happened on the 6th. 4.9 happened on the 6th. Don't have the DAP. This is the major tectonic plate right here. Okay. Again, New Zealand, the Northern Islands have some activity. That happened this week. I left off the date. I do apologize. 4.9. 86 miles in depth. Now, I've done talked about this I don't know how many times, but since it's going on the tube, I'm going to go over it again. I don't like repeating myself, but I have to. If a 6.5 hit anywhere on this section of the island, I'm not talking about way up there, no. I'm talking about right here, not out in the water, okay? Right here. It's going to open up the dormant chambers. This is a VEI-8 equal to the largest explosions of volcanoes. Oh gosh, if this happens, ladies and gentlemen, this area of this is a lake, okay? It's going to open up these chambers and it's going to go right down through here to this volcano, and it's going to explode. And I've talked about this I don't know how many times, and I'm not going to cover the possibility of a major tsunami hitting Australia. South America. Parts of Central America, but not America in general. Okay? I'm not going to do an illustration. This video is running over. I'm doing my best to educate all of you before I check out of the YouTube platform. I'm just giving you a heads up. So here we are, right here. It was a 5.3. This is the West Chile rise, happened on the 7th. Nothing really happened in the Pacific. Okay. We already covered this area. Panama. So now we're going to pick it up at New Zealand again. So here we go. 6.3. But a 7.0 hit. Back in March the 3rd. No activity in this area. But this one, different. Right here, right next to the 6. Almost the 6. Here's the 5.8. Happened on the 6th of this month. I hope everyone is not getting bored. It's a lot to cover in a short time. The time's running out. There's two of them right here. A 5.0, 6, aftershock, 4.9. Nothing really happened except for right here. This is Mongolia. And it was a 5.3, Mongolia, excuse me. Nothing going on here. Well, I already know about these. I already know about these, don't I? So now, we're going to get into the area of the Middle East. And would you believe another one? So I'm going to cover this again. Iran's underground nuclear testing facility is right here in this area. I was one of the first channels that reported on this. This is a 4.9 that happened this month. And this week, should I say, I left the date off again. I do apologize. 4.8 right here on the 5th. Now, it's been confirmed, okay, about this. Okay, can't make this stuff up. I don't know about other channels, but I don't do that. Right here in Turkey, 5.0, don't have the depth, happened on the 8th. We know about this one, 7.8 that hit Turkey, 2023, February the 6th. That over 53,000 people combined with what hit right here, 8.1 on the 6th. Now, this area of Greece, I believe we have a couple subscribers that live in Greece right here. 5.6, don't have the depth, happened on the 3rd. 4.7, 51 in depth, happened on the 4th. And Greece is flooding and having major fires in that area. So is Spain, they're flooding too. 4.3 in Italy on the 8th. Now we're gonna pick it up down through here. Africa. Okay, this is the Great African Rift. I reported on this, I don't know how many times. 5.0 hit this area out there. A lot of fours going off. Volcanoes are going off in that area as well. This one, what I mean by that, this one right here, that is a major volcano right here. Doesn't look like it, does it? Mm-mm. These are volcanoes. Okay, right here, African continent is splitting, and we just may witness that. Oh man, I'll be glad to finish this one out. South Atlantic anomaly. Was the magnetic South Pole. So let's stroll up through here and finish this one out. This is the longest update on earthquakes I've ever done because of educational and then what happened with the 7.1 in Cuba. 5.4, Mid-Atlantic Ridge on the 9th. Nothing to see here. These are old, of course. Nothing to see here. 6.3, Mid-Atlantic Ridge, nothing to see here, do they? Here we go. Two of them on top of each other. I've been seeing that a lot lately. 5.0 on the 9th, but what kicked it off was a 5.2 on the 4th. I already covered all of this and talked about it, and not going to talk about it that much, but if a magnitude 6 hits in this inside of this circumference, it's over for the people that live across the pond. This area, we're talking about a major tidal wave that come up through here. These are clusters. Now it's going to change, everyone. Okay, just want to let you know, I'm ready to finish this one out. So, this is the area of the 40 degree mark. Now I went back and did some adjustment on this map. And this is going to be interesting. They're all cluttered up right here. I want to try to let people know. Start over here the first week. August, only a quarter of a mile, 0.25. Second week, 0.25. Okay. Third week, 0.25. Right here. On the fifth week, right here. Second. Third. It moved backwards 1.7 miles. Wow. Magnetic north moved back 1.25 miles from the 40 degree mark. Okay. Which is here. These are old indications. Okay. Last year, only 3.5 miles in January. Okay. February of this year, 4.5 miles. March of this year, 5.5 miles. Maybe 5.6 miles in April. This is an estimate, and I hit it very closely. May the 4th. Came right out on it. Estimate for June. It did move 6.5 miles. The magnetic north moved 6.5 miles in July. Magnetic north moved 7.25 miles in August. 41 degrees. Okay. Stay with me. August. So if you take this number, almost 8 miles, 7.25 miles, August 31st, 6.25 miles, September, 8.7 miles, October. So it's accelerating, it's increasing. Okay. Now, this is my estimate for November. At the end of the week, I'm predicting 9.5 miles, 41.5 degrees. Estimate, 10.5 miles. Estimate, 12 miles. You know why? Because the geomagnetic storms are coming in, and I add that into my model, my calculations, 42 degrees. 13.5 February next year, 15 miles March of next year, 16.5 miles April of next year. Oh, what is this? 43 degree mark estimate, 20 miles estimate, June. 25 miles. Now, I hope that's not right, but that's what I came up with. 44 degrees. Right there. Estimate, 30 miles. So that's telling me we'll be at 45 degrees. Very, very soon. Now, I want to clear something up while we're here. We're going to go back to March of this year. Okay? Right here. The individual on YouTube said that I said March that the magnetic north would flip. I never made that statement. Okay. The 40 degree mark, what I call the tipping point, ladies and gentlemen, is meaning that it's going to speed up, and it did. Okay. Slow down. All right. Look at all this. 40 degrees. So I think that individual didn't pay attention in the video. March 2024. I never stated that, you know, we're going to flip. Never did. Maybe that individual should watch the video and listen more clearly. So I'm going to roll this around. This is it, what we just covered in the educational part. right here. 1.1 million years ago, a BEI-8. Okay. So this is important, and that's why I spent hours putting it together for all of you, so you understand. If a magnitude 4.5 hit here in 2022 in April, there's one of them, but I don't have all of them going back to 2017 or 2022, because my map was compromised. So it's over right here. This area inside the red zone, 43 degrees. Okay. What I'm getting at, once we get inside this zone, we just don't have the governments, and neither do I, anybody else has the technology and the data to put into a quantum computer. It's a guessing game. I don't like that. Okay. This is what I was talking about right here. We're going to go over it very quickly in this one. Right here. The South Pole. Was. This is the South Atlantic Anomaly. I don't know what that is. Maybe you look it up. Now I'm going to take you on a brief tour and finish this one out, because I'm ready. Follow the arrow. Okay? Just follow it. Straighten this up for you so you can see what I'm talking about. Very sensitive. When that South Pole heads to the North Pole, they're going to flip. It's going to go right into Siberia. And it's going to end up approximately in this area. Then it's over. Okay. When that happens, ladies and gentlemen, I'm just trying to educate all of you. We're going to go into an area that basically, they don't know. The quantum computers, it's not enough data, okay? But what's going to happen is this. The Earth's crust is going to separate from the upper mantle. And the crust is going to slide. And when that happens, we're going to be rotating backwards the correct way. So, I believe I am ready to end this one. So, I'm going to give you something. I'm going to end it right here, okay? I'm going to give you something to think about. Brother Joseph from Revelation Station did a video called The Great Global Earthquake Prophecy. And we're going to watch that one and end this one. But I want to say thank you all. Thank you all of you. Those who are on Rumble, Patreon, of course. That's number one platform for me. And my subscribers. Thank you for those who are on YouTube. If you're interested in Rumble or Patreon, the link is in the description box. As always. Because I don't think I'm coming back to YouTube. And the reason why is very simple. The last video I put up over there, only about 10 people went to Rumble. But I want to thank them. Because you're going to find me on Patreon and on Rumble. I don't think I'm coming back to YouTube. I really don't. They're trying to take me down to the ground. So let's watch Brother Joseph's great earthquake prophecy. God bless everyone. Be safe. Be strong. Sending you all many blessings of love and understanding through our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.